The sharing table is back and in full effect, just in time for Christmas. Typically on Thursday mornings is when I record my basement decluttering videos. And we were hosting the sharing table the same time as I record the basement. And the sharing table is a huge event that I set up where we declutter and take clothes that our children and ourselves no longer fit in. And also for Christmas, we're bringing in toys. We bring it all together and it's basically a huge clothing swap. At the end of the meeting, we shop for new things for our families. So technically, I am decluttering my basement today because this is the stuff that was down there that I had separated for the sharing table. So I'm glad that technically I did do a basement declutter. I'm also going to be sharing how I set up my clothing swap in case anyone would love to set up their own sharing table in their community. And I host our sharing tables at our church during our MOPS Mom Next events because these groups have a very large amount of mamas. So it's a perfect time for us to set up the tables and get all of this ready. The first thing I do is label the tables by clothing size. It makes it a lot easier for everyone to shop because they'll go to that table and pick out the clothes that they need for their children in that size. Next, make sure you find volunteers to help you that day because it is a lot of work to put all the clothes on top of the tables. This group right here between the two groups is probably about 80 women. So potentially I have 80 mamas bringing in clothes and bags. That's a lot of work because we do it all in one morning. So make sure you have volunteers ready to help you. The next tip is the most important one. Before your event, have every mama already have the clothes divided by size and into one labeled bag. It makes setup so much faster because all you have to do is bring the 4T bag to the 4T table and then start placing everything upon it. This will save you hours of sorting. And make sure to just keep the sizes in order so that people can just walk alongside the table until they get to their child's age. Now, setting everything out is going to take the most time because even though, yeah, each bag is labeled and you know what size category it goes in, you still have to take the time to lay everything out. And this meeting, we have a lot stuff. These mamas were encouraged to declutter and get their spaces back. And I think another reason why I had an overwhelming amount of stuff was because I gave them enough time. I created the post 2 weeks ago to give them plenty of time to go through their closets, to go through the playroom, to start bagging up their items. And it was kind of cool to see how excited they were to get it out of their house. Like, that was crazy to me to see pretty much all of them so happy to get it out of their house. Like, to me, that's like, it's, I get it now. But when I first started doing this 8 years ago, it was just like eye-opening to me that everyone else felt like that. And during this Christmas season, I've been really focusing on no-buys or swapping for something that you actually need. Because normally, I always overspend and buy. And I'm trying to break that habit because what happens? We buy a lot in December. A lot of stuff comes into our house from Christmas and then we spend all of January decluttering it. So if I can stop it at its source and be mindful of that, come January, I don't have to worry about decluttering or cleaning the new stuff that came in. I can just focus on the old stuff that I had stashed in the basement for years. And I just had to share this really quickly because this was once Brandon's jammies, then Tyler wore them, then I decluttered it and brought it to the last sharing table. And guess what? It's coming back again. Her child must have outgrown it, and now it's back here. And guess what? Someone else got it again for a fourth time. And I just think that that's awesome. It's awesome that that pair of Ninja Turtle jammies and all of these toys are going to be played with and worn again. Because this is my favorite part. When everything is set up and all the mamas come in to shop. Now, of course, for privacy reasons, we're not showing any faces, and they are aware that I am recording this for a video. But this is the part that is most fulfilling for me. This is what makes it worth all the hard work, because I get to see the mamas excitedly pick out new clothes for their children. It's providing a need in their families and saving them a lot of money too, so that they can use that money for other opportunities. It's also not going in the trash, which means it's not going to be in a landfill for years and years. These clothes get recycled a lot. I've been doing it for 8 years. I've seen a lot of the same pieces recycled through. They're trashed when they're finally at a trash point with holes and stains and torn. So to me, there are so many benefits to hosting a sharing table. But I think what's most special is creating that community together. We are a community of mamas that are taking care of each other. And I think that is the most awesomest part of it all. Another tip that I wanted to share with everyone is to make sure you encourage your mamas in your community post to bring extra plastic bags for shopping. Because as we start to wrap this up, you're going to see that there's still a lot of stuff left over that you're going to have to start bagging up. And as the last wave of mamas comes through to pick up their new treasures, you are going to want to have another team. And this team is to help you bag everything up, because that is another big job to do. And what we do once they're all done their shopping is that we bag everything up and donate it to a charity locally to us. And that's really all that I do. I keep it very simple. It's a very quick, simple, and easy process. There's some work to it, no doubt, but man, is it worth it? Is it worth it to help your community, to help other families get clothes and toys? Some of those toys are going to be put underneath their Christmas tree, and it didn't cost them anything, which is awesome. Plus, they also made a lot of space in their playroom to add those new toys in, so it's not overwhelming. And speaking of overwhelming, look at this Jeep. This Jeep is packed all the way to the tippy top, but it is all good because I have the clothing drop right here on the church's property. So at least I can immediately drop off all the clothes right away. So again, another bonus. We're donating it to a charity. The charity is going to dispense the clothes to other mothers and other children and babies in need. Again, we're not throwing it out. At least on our end, we're not throwing it out, to bring me a little peace of mind here. So you're probably wondering, well, what did you get, Miss Hart? Well, let me tell you how good I did. At the end of the shopping experience, no one had picked up these Christmas jammies that were new with tags, and my neighbor just had a baby, and I thought how sweet it would be to gift these to them so that her baby can wear it for this Christmas season. The next thing I got was a sweater for myself in the next size up, because I may have gained a few pounds this fall, and some of last year's sweaters were a little tight. I mean, all good. It's all good, right? Because I'm going to go back to being mindful about eating and exercising, and maybe in the future that'll be a video that I'll create too. And once I get back to my original size, I'll let this sweater go again. It always works out in the end.